This move is expected to weed out quirky engineers and grow the confidence of professionals in the industry. According to Andrew Muhizi, the president of the institute, the registration certificates will help return sanity to an industry that has in recent years recorded collapsing of buildings.
Even in the workplaces, it is possible that somebody may be working with an employer who that person could be the first engineer to be employed in that organization. Maybe they are being supervised by a non-engineer. That's why our mentorship program comes in.
As huge contracts are handed to unqualified personnel, Muhizi noted that engineers go through a process of mentorship as a way of ensuring they meet the code of ethics.
We have even simplified the processes now. If, for instance, somebody had a diploma and has been working before, went back and upgraded to degree level, that person will not do 4 years, they will instead do 2 years post-graduation, and they can get on the register. But if a person has not had previous work experience, is fresh from university, this one will have to go through the 4 years. And those 4 years, the first 2 years, you work under supervision.
They commended government's role in promoting strong policies to eliminate fake engineers. Currently, the country has over 1,400 registered engineers, but the Engineers Registration Board fears there is declining standards. Story by Aloysius Kasoma for the news.